Dear me, 8 years ago, you were innocent enough to underestimate the consequences, but curious enough to know. Just staring at that computer screen, not knowing you were opening up the front door to your new home. A humble abode, equipped with a window, a view into a distant future of addiction soon to make itself your own. You were 11 years old. Started with just a glance, years later these pixels caught you in a trance, just one of the 90% of teenage boys who never stood a chance. Pornography. A man-made invention intended for recreation turned into the world's quietest addiction. The industry makes more combined revenue than the MLB, NFL, and NBA annually. Porn sites comprise 12% of the internet, and 28,000 people are watching it every second. And ladies, I know you're not exempt, because one out of every six of women is an addict. But I mean, for you, it started out controllable. You were introduced to it by your best friend's older brother who convinced you it was only natural. So naturally, you followed your curiosity down this yellow brick road of secrecy, secretly seeking the affections of girls who you would never even meet. And slowly with time, you built a tolerance. You bought into this bliss with your common sense, and ever since have been convinced that this is your only true happiness. Man, it's sad how sex slavery is unacceptable until it's put on the internet. But I mean, accessing this drug, it's still too easy. My dealer is a computer screen who lives in the same house as me. This digital chemical dopamine is free and the supply never ending. Imagine the gluttony. Having whatever image you want to see or any video whenever you want to watch it. And oh, that I mentioned, your addiction is now portable. It fits in your pocket. See, you quickly learn how to burn down these firewalls only to get burnt, and then these images branded themselves to the inside of your eyelids. So even when you close your eyes to sleep at night, you can't escape them. But wait, it gets worse. They've installed these images into your brain. Now they won't leave you alone. Constant click, click, clicks like a metronome. Pornography embedded into your mind like a squeaking saxophone. Lust plays like tambourines and cymbals that change up the tempo. Your own flesh plays like notes that build to a sinful crescendo. Ultimately separating you from the maestro. But that's the plan, right? Get kids who can't defend themselves hooked early so they become a consumer for the rest of their life. I started to realize I couldn't stop, that I didn't even want to, that I sat in school impatiently waiting to get home and do what I've been craving to do. When you feed your addiction feeds on you, and the things you play with in high school as an adult will play with you. See, it's kind of like Back to the Future, except there's no Doc Brown. There's no DeLorean DMC. Marty McFly wouldn't believe his eyes if he saw the things these eyes have seen. No, I have invented the time machine. But there's no future to go to like in the movies. No, you just start back and repeat the same scene you have already seen. This habitual habit has inhabited me. I'm sick of trying to clean myself up by deleting my website history. See, I never called myself an addict because I thought I could control it. Until I was up at 4 in the morning, losing sleep, getting closer to that computer screen but farther away from sobriety. Look at myself in the mirror but not recognizing me, water in my back pocket but no identity. And see, I got it bad. If I ushered all these confessions, there would be more than a part two. I'm stuck to this addiction like glue, my views on sex totally skewed. But isn't it true? Our culture raped the beauty of sex, and yet we ended up being abused. It is the curse of an addict to chase that which destroys you. This is the silent addiction of today's youth. Let's do the math. Take the 93% of boys and 62% of girls exposed to pornography before age 18. Subtract the values of manhood and add boys who only get with girls to hide their insecurities. Minus the beauty stolen from girls who add makeup to make up for who that guy wants him to be, that double negative alone equals a positive pregnancy. And so she carries the baby alone because that boy was reduced to a coward. It took a taste of lust in his whole life and ended up being devoured. Now she can't sleep at night because she cries for hours. Don't you see this equation is missing a higher power? And so I'll write to you with desperation in my voice. Addiction may have taken you captive, but freedom is a choice. And I'll be honest, I don't have a 12-step program, informative pamphlet, or strategic plan. I have no vaccine or visine to help you see past your past, but let me pass you what I do have. I have a savior. His compassion's new every day. His faithfulness stays. He made a way out of no way. Turned my darkness into day. This sacrifice made, our ransom paid. He took our place. Blood pouring down his face as he replaced our disgrace with his grace. Buried for 3 days, but death cannot contain. He left death in his grave. Death died that day. So the sin you claim, the games you play, the feelings of shame, are already forgiven in Jesus' name. Because even though my sin delivered the whips that ripped the skin from his bones, on a cross he would die to deliver me home. See, he saved my life, so I owe him everything, and he loves me with no conditioning. So I no longer try to get in shape or lose this weight before surrendering. Love came down and ransomed me. So forget Romeo and Juliet, the Princess Bride, and the Notebook. This is the best love story I've ever seen. But I gotta be real. Every day is a battle. And sometimes I lose. But this I know to be true. The victory in addiction is not a retreat, it's a pursuit. And so I conclude. And I promise I'm almost done. But God is the only thing that will set you free from being numb. Not in your own strength, but in His name, you can overcome. You have victory over this addiction. Signed, Sincerely Freedom.